Welcome back to Final Fantasy VIII. Here we go. We just found out that we became SeeD, or we passed the final exam in Dalit, and we're going to continue on now to see what happens next. So this battle meter here, it'll give you information on like what you've done throughout the game, or like how many monsters you fought and things like that. I'm not actually sure if this is a missable item or not, but you have to talk to SeeD here to get it for the first opportunity to get it. So now we go down the elevator. After 17 years of suffering, my chance has finally arrived. Oh, whoa, what, Nomad? That's Nina. I think his name is Nina. And Selfie and Zale, obviously. SeeD! Yo, Nomad, let's get back to class. What do you mean, why? Don't you remember what new SeeD members do? They give a speech in front of the entire class, and after that, the inauguration party. They're ready to have a fight with him. Shows pretty good respect of your fellow classmates. So this right here is going to be your initial SeeD ranking. Like everything that you did in the Dalit mission and the Fire Cavern and things like that. There are ways to make this, you know, more perfect. For my purposes, I wasn't too concerned with getting a super high score, but SeeD rank 5 isn't really all that great. But the SeeD rank can be raised throughout the game by doing certain things, acting certain ways around people, and there's also tests you can take to raise it. So if you need to, you can do that. There's easier ways to get money though. You can use like the infinite money thing, and I think it's Healing City later in the game. So, go through this. As a SeeD member, you will be paid a salary at regular intervals. The salary is determined by SeeD rank. SeeD rank goes up according to your actions in battle. Some actions will cause your rank to go down. Ha! Found you! Well, what do you think? My SeeD uniform. You should get changed too. We have that party to go to. You should get changed too. We have to go to the party. Here we go. Life of the party. Hey, looking good. All right, let's hit the party. Yo! What's up, Nomad? Hey, I guess we're both SeeDs now, huh? Look there, man. Even as a SeeD, you're still the same. Well, that's typical of you. See ya! Oh, hey, Zell! Wanna join the Garden Festival Committee and... Sorry, just remembered something. Gotta go. See ya. Nomad, hi. Wanna join the Garden Festival Committee? You can help out whenever you have time. Please? Yeah, I guess so. Sure, you seem to be putting a lot of effort into this. Really? Woohoo! I know we'll be busy with a lot of seed stuff, but let's work hard on the garden festival too. Bye! You're the best looking guy here. Insert meme from PS1. Dance with me. Let me guess, you only dance with someone you like. Okay then. Look into my eyes. You're going to like me. Did it work? I can't dance. You'll be fine. Come on. I'm looking for someone. I can't be on the dance floor alone. This is great how she just like, hey, I need you to do this. And there is a thing here. He straight up lied to her about not being able to dance. He just didn't want to dance. Kind of the anti. He definitely knows how to dance. I'll reiterate on this later. He just gets really good all of a sudden, so. You really are an excellent student. Even that dance was perfect. Thank you. Yes? So you'll dance with someone you don't even know, but you can't stand being around me? Whatever. You're an instructor, and I'm your student. It's kind of awkward when you don't say anything. That's true. I was like that myself. Oh, I completely forgot. I wonder what's to become of me. I've come to give you an order. You and I are to go to the secret area. It's where students secretly meet up and talk after curfew. It's inside the training center. What do you want to do there? Are we going there to tell everyone they're violating curfew? If that's the case, forget it. Leave that for the disciplinary committee. Go get changed and meet me in front of the training center. This will be my last order. Get changed and meet at the training center. What's this all about? So it's late at night right now, and there's only one area actually open, which is the training center. So, Nomad, I was wondering, have you fought T-Rex R in the training center? I'm not sure. You can defeat it quite easily by using status junction. So this is going to teach you how to equip sleep to your status attack. I've already showed you how to do this, so tutorial skipped. Well, using a sleep junction attack. Okay, come on, let's go to the secret area. It's just inside the training center. Right, so let's get her and him junctioned up. She is going to get those two. So I'm using the switch command here to switch with Zale because he has magic on him, and basically when you use a switch command to swap junctions, it swaps all the magic and everything on the character as well as GS. So just as a quick tip. As for the Quetzalcoatl who I had on the selfie, I wanted to take that off specifically because I wanted to leave the magic on selfie. Now I'm also going to junction Blizzard to the elemental attack here because many things are weak to Blizzard magic in the training center. So. And I'm gonna check my GFs as well because why not? There will be a battle coming up here soon, and yeah. All right, all set up, ready to go. Do believe there is something in here. So we're gonna run over here. Not sure we're not missing anything. I think this is a blizzard. Yep, blizzard draw. Into the secret area. And it's basically make out point. I haven't been here for a while. I mean, she's been here before, eh? What time is it? It's after midnight. Oh well. I quit this trip and no longer an instructor as of now. I'm a member of SeeD now, just like you. Who knows, maybe we'll end up working together. Oh, really? Is that all you're going to say? If that's how it was decided, you have to abide by it. They told me that I failed as an instructor, basically that I lacked leadership qualities. I was a SeeD by the age of 15, got my instructor's license at 17. It's only been a year since I got it. I wonder where I went wrong. I did my best. Are you listening? Are you done yet? I don't want to talk about it. What am I supposed to say about other people's problems? I'm not asking you to say anything. I just want you to listen. Then go talk to a wall. Aren't there times when you want to share your feelings with someone? Everyone has to take care of themselves. So this is the first example of like squaws inner dilemmas and things, so, or nomads inner dilemmas and stuff that he's vulnerable. I don't care to carry anyone's burden, or I don't want to carry anyone's burden. No leadership qualities, failed instructor. Perhaps they're right. There's a boss fight coming up here in a second, so that I will be drawing from, so I will be cutting it during that. Somebody help! Come on, Nomad. Nomad! Nomad! Twisty! Alright, so the thing with this battle here is the only way the three on the ground attack is if the one in the air picks him up and drops him. So what we're going to do is we're going to put it to sleep and then we're going to draw. Now basically they won't attack as long as it's asleep. Now we're going to draw shells from the flyer and we're going to draw tech from the ones on the ground. Both of these junction very well for I think it's elemental defenses. And they give you pretty solid defense, so some of the best defense, but I mean they are defensive scales, so. Once I finish drawing all this, I will be back to finish the battle. Alright, so I did draw to 100 on both of those, and so the plan now is to keep the flyer asleep, and we're going to take out the ones on the ground. And we're going to do this because the ones on the ground can't attack if the flyer is alive. And they can't attack if the flyer is asleep because the flyer picks them up and drops them. And I think it's called Ronaldo. So we're going to put the flyer asleep. And we're going to take out things on the ground while they do nothing. Doing it this way means you basically can't die, so. They don't have a ton of health either, so they die pretty quickly. Now, when it comes down to the last one, though, I'm going to kill the flyer before I kill the last one. So now I'm going to kill the flyer first. And let's go and use this so that at least I've shown off Siren. Silent Voice. First round of silence. She is edited from the original game. Alright, so now that's dead, and the flyer is also thicker knowledge. Well, I know I said I was going to kill the flyer first, but I wasn't expecting the GF to kill it, so. Now, since Nomad has a sleep jump into his attack, well, I was going to say I was going to attack last, but I guess I killed it anyway, so. If I attack last, then it'll go to sleep, hopefully, on the hit. It's not safe here. Please, let's go. All right. Who was that? It's pretty telling that Quistus doesn't know who that was. But she knew who they were. Nomad, it's not like everyone can get by on their own, you know. Words of wisdom. Says who? Now we're just going to take a trip back to our dormitory and go to sleep. Finally, there you are. Where the heck were you? I was looking all over the place. We're both now members of SeeD, right? Well, guess what? We got our own rooms, baby. Your new room's right across the hall from your old one. That's what I was asked to tell you. Man, it took me forever. I'll just go to sleep. Nomad, it's our first SeeD mission. Looks like we're going to Timber. Meet by the front gate. Hurry! Alright, and that's going to do it for this mission, or this part. So on the next part, part 5, 6.